Got the best in the world right here. Not any better than this. I wish Buddy could still be here, but they're all great.
Buddy Rich is, he's there forever. I thought the guy was an outrageous drummer, forever and ever. And, you know, he might have passed away, but he's going to live on forever.
And I thought, why don't we start a scholarship program in his name, something that could sort of make his name live on. And that's how this whole thing started. There's such a mystique about him and his name and the gift that he had. When you talk about drums and you talk about drumming, you know, there, you can't get any higher than that. So everyone wants to be a part of it.
Well, I always saw him on a heavenly rank. Like, there were all the good drummers in the world, of which there are so many. And then I just took it for granted that Buddy Rich was up there, you know. That was one of the special things about this opportunity. Not only was it wonderful to be at all associated with the name of Buddy Rich, but to have a chance to play with a big band at last after all these years, and to mark my 25th anniversary with such a big challenge, which it was to me.
You interrupted the recording of Rush's new album to be here and to rehearse for this thing. Yeah. Please let me welcome Neil Peart.
But I felt the greatest tribute to the music, and certainly the biggest challenge to me would be to try to play the songs exactly as close as I am able to the way Buddy did. So in learning the way he played, I soon found that trying to figure out how he played was not the point. I had to figure out how he thought. I mentioned to Kathy a couple of weeks ago that I really felt that I'd been wandering around inside the brain of Buddy Rich, which is an amazing place to be, you know, just the way he thought about his playing. I think that's refreshed my whole interest in drumming, preparing for this event. You know, I hadn't really studied anybody else's drumming that closely for many years.
My father always said, a drummer is a drummer, and you shouldn't be called a rock drummer, or a jazz drummer, or a country western drummer. A drummer is a drummer, and you should be able to play in every situation. That's why these guys are excited to do this, because they're sort of labeled as rock drummers or jazz drummers, and this gives them a chance to sort of show that they can do something else. And I think that's exciting for them.
Duke Ellington said, there's only two kinds of music, good and bad. So if it felt good, if I got a good internal feeling from it, then I would check it out. I would go and investigate.
Hey, you guys know you can't touch this? I'm sorry. Wrong game. Sorry.
There's a definite lineage that happens from, you know, the field holler to the you know, gospel singing to ragtime to traditional New Orleans jazz to swing era to bebop to post bop, cool bop, neo bop, you know, post impressionistic bop, you know, rock and roll, R&B, fusion. I mean, you can just see hip hop, new jack, whatever, no wave, this wave, high wave. I mean, it's all in there. There's a direct lineage. There's some kind of common thread that happens. Yeah, because rhythm is at the center of it all.
I want you to welcome a gentleman who is unbelievable. He's gonna blow you all away. He's been on over 70 albums. He's played with some incredible people. And he played with Sting, he's played with Dave Holland, he's played with everybody. His name is Marvin Smitty Smith.
the significance of this event, it's a celebration, more or less, in memory or in tribute to Buddy's contribution, not only to drums as an instrument, but to this music, this American art form. Music transcends race, religion, sex. It transcends all of that. It's a reflection of the human heart. That's what Buddy represented. He was just a messenger of the music. You know, watching Buddy, you think you were watching a ninja movie, you know, Bruce Lee or something, you know, Fist of Fury or something, you know, and you just see these hands going and feet going, and they're just like not even breaking a sweat, and wearing a suit and tie or a tux or something, you know, button. And I said, that's the way to go. We'll be right back.
Thank you.
these incredible drummers, and they're all great, and they're all the best at what they do, and you put on a clip of Buddy, and everybody stops, all the drummers stop, everybody's watching, and they shake their heads. And he's still the star of the show, and he's not even here.
He had this magical energy on the drum set that really fired a band. And he also had an incredible drum technique that still I've never seen anyone match at all. So it's a real honor to be involved in an event like this in his memory and to play his music with his band. The type of music that we're playing is really challenging. Is very demanding for a drummer because you have to play time, you have to play a lot of fills, and the drums are featured a lot in this type of music, which is different than a lot of the things that I do. So that puts a lot more responsibility on me to really come across with the goods. When they sent me the charts and the tapes, there were tunes that I had heard when I was a kid, and I used to like listening to them, and I even would like play along with the records a little bit, but it was a completely intimidating thing to realize, well, I got to play these tunes now. And
he might get a kick out of it, you know, like hearing all of us scuffling with his band.
me, this is a very pure musical event. Different than a lot of situations that are, you know, there's a more of a commercial reason to do it or something, but this feels like music, pure and simple. I'm really focused on just doing a great job playing my instrument and playing with this band. At the time that I played with Journey, it was exactly what I wanted to do. I was 23 years old when I joined the band, and I stayed until I was 30 years old, and it was great. It really was musically what I wanted to do, and just, I guess, image-wise, and it gave me a good platform to go out in the world as an individual too after that. It helped open doors. At this point in my life, it's not really what I want to do. I feel a lot more closer to my own sense of who I am when I'm playing the jazz music. That feels better to me. It demands more of me as a musician, and I like that feeling. it isn't very often that I get to play with another drummer, and it's always a lot of fun. It's interesting and inspiring and challenging to get out there and to just play together, trade 8-bar phrases or whatever back and forth, and push each other to play the most we can play, you know, to play to our highest level possible. And there's, in a way, no better way to do that than to have another drummer breathing down your neck.
Everybody wants to do their best. Everybody wants to be on their top ship shape. Then there's a little element like, well, of course you want to sound better than the other guy, but at the same time, you have to look at the overall context of the situation. This is an event of celebration. This is to celebrate a man and his music and his craft. Once we keep that in mind, then we can always have fun, you know. And it'll be a healthy competition, but it'll be done within the spirit of achieving to the level of the person we're celebrating, because he achieved that level.